You are awake, my friend. How long? You were gone for about an hour or so. Worry not. You breathed in a lot of gas, but I've seen worse. I gave you treatment for your lungs while you were asleep. For now, you should feel better, but it will wear off. Mainly, I can see you are exhausted. It is hard for me to help you with that. We need to get you out of here, my friend. This town is not safe. Soon, it would all be coming down. You are stubborn, eh? My friend, you must listen. If your brother is in Fort Vaux, it is no place for one lone soldier. It is the German stronghold. There is more in there than you think. Most of our men who went over are gone. Not many made it to the fort. It is a very bad situation now. If there are men who made it there, it is not enough to make a difference. I can see in your eyes that nothing I say will matter here. I understand. For my brothers, I will do the same. Well then, my job here is done. Before you go, there are supplies for you over there. I hope they help you. Me? There are still injured men here in this town, so I will stay. Stay alive, my friend. Do not let it be a waste. Ah, and one last thing, my friend. Listen carefully. Before I found you, I found another of ours. He was from Vaux, and he told me that. Where did that come from? He's not responding. We finally made it to Fort Vaux. Man, they're everywhere. The door has been boarded shut. Only way to remove the metal bars is with a wrench. If only we kept the entrenching tools. Yeah, I really need a flashlight down here. I can hear people stomping around. You can go further down below. An empty octagonal indentation. It's so very Silent Hill-like down here. That didn't hit either of them. Try and see if I can have you fall down the same spot. Yeah. Didn't think I was that close. Can I run through here? Yeah, that kills me quick. Went full on Dark Souls on your ass. That's where we use the lockpick on. German Diary. April 1st, 1916. New Year's passed quickly this year. We have been preparing for an important battle. For the first time in months, supplies have been plentiful. Most of our daily routine involves transporting crates from trains and cars. No mail today, but I spent the evening writing letters. The preparation for the upcoming battle is winding down. Many companies share the same order, and we are moving now to the front line. I have never seen so many soldiers before. Our superiors have said that this will be the battle to end this terrible war. They are calling it Operation Judgment. And so, we are expecting a hard fight in a few weeks' time. But now, the landscape is still. The winter has been harsh, but the birds have started to come out. They sing and it reminds me of the farm. It is very beautiful here, in all honesty. One letter from my wife. The war has made her quite distressed, but she says Anna makes her happy on those days. She does her little dance, and she smiles. I look forward to seeing that little dance again. February 16th, 1916. Slow day today. Today was rather slow and uneventful. After our rifle inspection, a letter was delivered from my wife. She has fallen ill and is feeling depressed. Clara will be looking after her. I am thankful. And so today, I have not been feeling well at all. I still had guard duty at 1600, but it was a quiet and lonely evening. The birds keep me enough company here. February 21st, 1916. First assault. The thrill of battle has fallen upon us. In the morning, an artillery duel began that has been raging on for the entire day. It feels like the earth is moving beneath us. Every hour, it grows louder. We will be advancing when the night falls, after the French positions have been pulverized. No mail today. Very hungry. Nothing is moving anymore. The landscape has turned barren. I cannot compare it to anything I have seen. Birds are quiet still. I don't think they are here anymore. A shell hit the mess hall this morning. No food for the company. In our past lives, consider this morning ruined by a yearning stomach. But here, we are just happy to be alive. Our superiors told us a shell would never hit the sector we were told to dig the new mess hall in. I think those who made that decision should be the ones going on without food. Three letters today. My wife is not feeling better, so Aunt Clara has taken her to the doctors. It is hard to be so far away. On Wednesday, we had a victory that will turn the tide of this battle. I am thankful to be alive. A grand fortress in the hills by the commune of Vaux devant Damloop was surrendered after 3 days of fighting. Our company was to go over on the second day with flamethrowers. A firefight broke out immediately. During the skirmish, Max was shot dead by a hairy Frenchman with a green scarf. It's hard to remember what happened. Once we made it past the large hill, another Frenchman donning a red scarf threw a bomb at my feet. The blast swept me off my feet and I landed in a nearby ditch. If only the birds could see how high I flew. Thank God my legs are intact. My ankle was in tremendous pain when I tried to stand. I spent the whole day and night there. I only recall parts, but remember being terribly alone. I am now in the medical bay of the fort. Letters this week are late due to the fighting. Feeling stuck. Two letters today, one from Uncle Otto, one from Clara. She writes that my wife was admitted to the hospital on the same day that I was injured. She is not getting well and has stopped speaking. A cruel joke. I would walk back home with one leg if they let me. Clara says she will send letters if there's good news. I look forward to the good news. Nothing happening. The silence in our infirmary was broken today by a superior berating a younger lad for turning back during the battle. We give orders from the back. That is easy. It is harder to clean the latrines. It's not him who knocks on our mother's door. That is the biggest injustice. We don't ever say it. We never will. No mail today. They say the next letter delivery will be a week away due to the torn up roads. Very bored. It's quite boring here. Lieutenant Schmidt needed a code for his new French locker in the weapon storage, and he couldn't figure out a code, so he asked me. Random numbers came to mind. The time of the afternoon I used to have guard duty, the number of French flags in this dastardly room, the day in June we had victory at Fort Vaux. These are the monotonous things that make up your day here. Still no mail. Roads must be in a bad way. June 26, 1916. There's no mail today. Well, that's depressing. Exactly where that key goes. I wonder what that's for. I wonder if it's for that locked door that we found earlier. Not sure if I'm ready to jump down that hole yet. Yeah, screw it, let's go in there. Buddy, did you not hear all that go down in the room next to you? Thank you. Let's go ahead and use the morphine. What is this emblem used for exactly? Oh, it's probably half of that octagonal piece that I need. You should have just let me take the spark plug, man. There's an intruder in the fort. Be alert. Somebody infiltrated the fort and opened it up to the enemies. Why are the rats not attacking the German soldiers? It's so weird. If it's worth fighting them, maybe it's better if I just dodge them all. Generators have been installed to power lights and internal fans for Fort Vaux. The generator on the left is connected to the downstairs power. The one on the right is for upstairs. Newly installed fans are enough to clear rooms of gases. It is advised they are kept on during an attack. Okay, I can freely swap the spark plugs between both generators. But the one on the left, that's for downstairs. Got one. Come over here. You know you want to. Thank you. I have a grenade right here. Rats shouldn't be a problem here anymore. I really should have used that grenade in more spots, but every time I found a hole, I never had a grenade on me. I honestly don't understand how sometimes the cursor is super smooth like this, and other times it's shaking horribly around. I don't get it. Here we go, another hole to jump down into. Oh, good thing they put a save room down here. There are some legitimately creepy rooms down here in this fort. Is this like a secret save room? There's so many supplies here. Look at all the gems. We got more than enough room to pick up anything that comes our way. Oh, I absolutely love this shotgun, baby. What's going on with this room? Why can't I break down this wall? It doesn't look like there's actually an entryway or exit, rather. So why would they put up this boarded up wall here? It looks like you could break through. Nice try, buddy. Oh, sweet. It goes all the way back over there. Nice. Oh, damn it. Wasn't expecting a damn fire bat to sneak up on me. Medical attention, baby. And what's with this dog tag? A French dog tag from a fallen soldier. The front reads, Gerard Albert, 1915. Inscribed on the back is the number 2160. This has to be for one of the lockers. Where is this spot in the fort? The valley? It's like a gigantic underground fire beneath the fort, man. Here's the elegant gemstone. So we don't need this anymore. Cavalry saber. Probably the most damage dealing one. Stop kicking me! I mean, the saber's nice, and it does have a lot of durability, but I think I'm just gonna stick to just shooting them. Yeah, especially this guy. Yeah, we're just blowing through these enemies now. The double-barreled shotgun and sweeper combo. It's too OP. The wrench. Finally. Locked from the other side. Whoa, I'm all the way over here. Okay. Go, baby. The metal bars have been removed. When are we gonna find our brother, dude? Yeah. You're kind of easy to deal with now with the shotgun. The lion key, finally. Been looking all over for this damn key. Oh, I meant to equip the saber. That leads back to there. We're just gonna go ahead and discard the axe. The lion door. There should be a lion door down here somewhere. There's actually not a lion door. Oh, hold on. Wait a minute. The pronged keys go to this door, doesn't it? I think I found all three pronged keys. They do work on this door. I had the first prong key since the first chapter, I think. Take the Spandau. Is that another machine gun? Messenger pigeon. It's alive, and the coop is open. I need something to carry it in. I don't have anything to carry it in. I'll be back, I think. A modified portable heavy machine gun. It has been made lightweight compared to the original model. The initials BM are engraved on the side. Oh, it's this guy again. Oh, the gas mask filter. Andre. Got any? Yes, Gaston. I got smokes. Take this. He's dead. Most peaceful I've ever seen him. Take the Mustang 11. American horsepower. Honestly, I thought Gaston here was like a figment of my character's imagination, but nope, he's just another comrade who died in the war. American made semi-automatic pistol. Fast fire rate, reliable, and very powerful. Has excellent stopping power and penetration ability. That looks like a 1911. We can use this gas mask and enter the mess hall. And there is the last emblem quarter. The text on the wall reads, better to perish under the ruins of the fort than to surrender it. So that's where Pierre is. He's under the fort. Like, obviously that's where he's at because we haven't come across him since. But he's probably fighting down to the last man. Here we go. Last locked door. There's no way this is under the fort. Has my character gone completely insane here? More money, huh? We probably have a big fight coming up. There's a hole in the floor here. It doesn't look like there's any way back from down there. Jump down? Yes, we have nothing else to lose. Bars of the gate have been contorted. They won't budge. He's not responding at all. He looks to be on the verge of death. His eyes and face have completely sunken in. His mouth is moving, but no words are coming out. He is in complete shock. There's the helmet. Pierre? Oh no, Pierre. Andre, I, Ma. He's not responsive, but he's still alive. I need to secure the fort, then I'll get you out of here, brother. Oh, here we go. We have the big one last stand coming up. Don't you have anything to say about Fort Vaux, about the events that's happened so far? You still haven't told me your name. I'm glad you found your brother, Poilu. He'll be okay. I'm sure of it. I will hold this position for you. Go and do what you need to do, mate. I have a feeling this will be our last meeting, Poilu. Strike them like lightning in our final storm. If you need anything, let me know. I saved the body armor for the end. We're going to go ahead and equip that. Assign the spadal to the bottom. And we are ready. Let's do this, folks. Wow, I can actually block these areas off. That we have plenty of grenades. This is a huge battlefield. How many people are they going to send after me? The door appears to be locked from the other side. Where are they coming from? Right here, right where you want me. Come get me. Damn, that critical shot. Oh man, Audrey, you are a beast. Body armor is holding up. I'm trying to save my spindle here for these guys specifically. Oh man, that spindle tore through that guy. I'll be stacking bodies here all night. That surgical kit coming in handy. Oh, this guy got stuck. That's unfortunate. Let's go. That's all good, man. I wouldn't want to fight me either. There's even more out there. Go out. Hell yeah. We haven't even burned through half our ammo, bro. Let's go ahead and test this grenade. Those guys are like nothing now to me. You guys are just simply no match for my shotgun at this point. It just wrecks ass. Andre is just a killing machine at this point. These are real people, right? Or they're supposed to represent real people. Pick up Pierre? Yes. Absolutely, why would I not? Where is there to go? Shit. Take the contorted key. Oh, I see. Andre. Oh no, Pierre's gonna die. I'm sorry. My leg. I can't feel my legs. Watch. He's gone. Damn it, did I screw up? It had to do something with that pigeon I had trapped in my carrier. Was I supposed to release it at some point? I don't know. I'm sorry, Pierre. And now I gotta play as the mother visiting their only child left. The 1,000-yard stare. The things I had to do to survive. During the summer months, English support at the Somme helped alleviate pressure for the French in the hills of Verdun. Battle of Verdun would come to a close in December of 1916 after a Pyrrhic French victory. 300,000 men had sacrificed their life for negligible territorial gains. The scale of death in such a small area would have Verdun amply named the Meat Grinder by many of the men who witnessed its horror. Total casualties would exceed 700,000. For many of the men who were lucky to come home, a new battle was waiting for them. The but the wounds inflicted from this battle were not physical. And they will never heal.
What the hell is going on here? I just thought I got a bad ending. These are the photos of the people I've killed. That sounded like a bullet grazed past me. What the hell? They're back. So he's just reliving his time in the war over and over in his head.
I already had a feeling that Pierre was gonna die. Maybe there are different endings where he can survive, but I'm not entirely sure. But that was a pretty good game.
I have to say that was pretty overwhelming. I was a lonely French soldier and I was fighting against the German army. There was wave after wave of enemies. And I felt like what ruined my experience was those damn rats. I'll be honest. I hated the rats. I didn't like them. I think that they were the worst part of the entire game. And to an extent, they affected my overall mood while I was playing the game. I would have preferred the developer threw more German soldiers my way. Had more of the German army in my trenches, more of them to fight against. That way I would have been pressed more to use the wire spool, because I did not use a single wire spool at all. It wasn't the German army that was the threat, and that's what kind of kills the vibe for me a bit in this game. There were times where I walked into a hallway and I saw one lone German soldier walking between 10 freaking rats, and the rats didn't pay attention to them. But the moment that I walked closer, the rats assaulted me, plus the German soldier came after me too as well. But let me know what you all think in the comments below. I really hope you all enjoyed watching it as much as I enjoyed playing it. This has been Pazigal. Take care, everybody.